guys no more. You know, Lomachenko, he's small for that division. Mouse, you don't want to play no wars home. I left my game at home. I'm out here in the mountains, bored, nothing to do. So I'm on live talking to you. Mikey got good timing, though. His feet might be slow, but him and Danny Garcia got good timing. Good timing. Sean Porter, a good fighter. You know what I mean? Sean Porter been fucking putting in work since, shit, I can remember when he was fucking fighting Danny Jacobs and Sean Estrada, big ass. Yeah. Could I beat you in 2K? I don't even play 2K, but I be getting dubs when I do. And I don't even play it. I'm just natural. I just know how to play the game. Who next? I don't know. I don't know. We still, you know what I mean? Waiting to see. Spectacular year. One step closer to becoming undisputed, hopefully. My honest opinion about Ryan Garcia. Ryan Garcia is talented, man. A lot of people don't give him a credit, you know, but with his speed and his power, you know what I mean? He can give anybody hell. Like, I think you need to sharpen up, you know, his punching selection and his defense and shorten up his punches a little bit. But other than that, you know what I mean? He good. He showed that, you know, he can box. But at the same time, he up. Luke Campbell ain't no joke. So he in a real fight. You know, this going to tell a lot about Ryan Garcia. I'm looking forward to seeing him in the top guys in his division. I like Spence too. I ain't got no problem with none of them, you know what I mean? Shit. My thing is, when it come down to it, we in the same division. You know, it's business. He think he's number one. I feel I'm number one. And that's where the friction becomes a issue. You know, somebody got to be number one. We both can't be claiming to be the best in the division if we ain't fought each other. So that's where I'll leave it at. I've been calling all of them out since I was at 140. You know, I come up to the 147 division and everybody say, get a belt. I get a belt. Then everybody having excuses. Then the fans run with it. Oh, he's on the other side of the street. I have never heard that ever in my life until now. You never hear that with nobody else but Terence Crawford. They made up a whole street divided boxing with Terence Crawford and everybody else. When that ever happened? All they had to do is just say, we weren't going to fight you because of certain situations, you know? But the crazy part about it is, correct me if I'm wrong, and a lot of y'all gonna see this, and a lot of y'all was blogging about this, and y'all was talking about this. Wouldn't nobody mention Terence Crawford's name until they start losing? That's when PBC and I&M and whoever they handle it. Oh, well, now y'all can go over there. But when people was champion, you ain't never heard them say, oh, let's unify with Terence Crawford, or let's fight Terence Crawford. It was Terence Crawford got to get a belt, or what Terence Crawford done in the welterweight division, or it was always something, or he's on the side, other side of the street, or Bob Arum. It was always something. But now, like I said before, I already fought two PBC guys. And I think Amir Khan was managed by Al Heyman or something of that nature. I don't want to say something that I don't know, but I think. But yeah, so if that's true, that's three fighters, right? But the top guys, when they was champions, when they had something to lose, it was don't say his name, don't nothing. But now you see things is changing. See, things is changing now. You know, you see Sean Porter say, oh, man, me and Bud can fight. Now you see Keith Thurman, oh, send a contract. Now you see who else? You're starting to see a lot of young fighters coming up, but that's what they're supposed to do. You know what I mean? They looking at the top guys in their division to get a title shot, and that's what we do it for. You know, you got to call out the top guys. When you coming up, that's how you get your name out there, and that's how you get your opportunity. So I don't knock none of them, but let's be real, man. Spence only really fought one guy, Kell Brook, and Kell Brook only fought one guy. You know what I mean? And that was Sean Porter. And Danny Garcia only fought two guys. Well, really once, I don't know, man, I'm different. I just look at, you know what I mean? Like, what have you done? Or what have they done that's so different than me? And they've been in this division longer than me. They fought each other, okay. So since they fought each other, that makes them, so if I beat Aegis, that makes him a top welterweight then. If I be but Jeff Horn was considered one of the biggest welterweights in the division. He never lost in the division, tell me. Then yeah. So everybody that I fought should be in the top 6-7. I'm just throwing it out there because I guess if they fight each other, then all of them considered in the top, whatever, they top welterweights because they get to fight each other. But what about the person that lose? He still ranked high? I don't get it. Somebody got to help me get it. Because every fight that I didn't fought, except the Khan fight, everybody was just like, man, you going to whitewash Khan. But every fight that I done fought in a welterweight division, everybody was like, man, you're going to lose. You're too small. I don't know. Some people, there's a lot of people that, you know what I mean, thought I was going to win. But how I win, that's when they say, oh, well, this guy's a bum. This guy is this. This guy is that. Terence Crawford ain't fought nobody. I ain't fought nobody. Dang. Everybody I fight, they say something bad about him after I fight him. Gamboa was too small. How was Gamboa too small when he just won a title prior to fighting me? Barry John was too small. I went up in weight and fought him. And he just fought Lamont Peterson that everybody praised when somebody beat Lamont Peterson. Good fighter though, but you know, people used him as you know what I mean, beat Lamont Peterson, you the shit. But I don't worry about it. I just laugh because I just be having to remind y'all what y'all be saying that don't make sense to me, like Victor Postol, how y'all talk way down on Victor Postol, like a lot of y'all writers. But prior to that, he made Danny Garcia pay him step aside money and move up and wait. He didn't want to fight him. Dang. Y'all forgot about that. Then what I do to him? Then y'all get mad and say, oh, he just won the mention and this and that, that. But then he fight Josh Taylor and Ramirez. And them fights was closer than a motherfucker. I honestly think him and Ramirez could have went either way, or it was a draw, because he was popping Ramirez with that fucking jab and right hand. But I ain't gonna get no credit until I'm done with boxing. For real, I'm telling you, all these fighters that I have fought, when I, they wasn't no bum, level than them. Everybody bums in everybody's eyes. Guys, good fighters, you know what I mean? It's just, you know, sometimes, you know, you'll look at a fighter and you'll be like, man, that dude can fight. He really can fight. Then when you fight another fighter that really, really can fight, you'd be like, fuck. Man, he was weak. He won all that. But in reality, you just got to get that dude that he fought some credit, because he was just the better man that night. You know what I mean? It's kind of like Danny Garcia and Keith Thurman. Both of them motherfuckers can fight. You know what I mean? But one got to win, one got to lose. But you can't say the next motherfucker's a bum because he lost. Put up a good fight. Shit, look at Sean Porter and Errol Spence. Nobody gave Sean Porter credit. But when I kept telling everybody it's a 50-50 fight, people was like, ah, Errol Spence gonna knock Sean Porter out and this and that. Alright, fight come down to everybody. Sean Porter. See how quick they switch up. But, I don't know. I'm bored, y'all. I'm gonna watch some movies or something. The Red Bull, we shall see. Some people's styles is ugly, but they get the job done. Caleb can fight too. Caleb can fight. Benavidez can fight. Steven Nelson. No, I gotta put my bro in there. Yeah, man, they can fight, man. I want to see Caleb playing fight Benavidez, though. That's going to be a good fight. I really want to see this. Hey, no cap. Benavidez against Canelo. I'm calling it right now. That's going to be one of the top fights if they ever fight. Tell them. Benavidez is fast. He can punch. He's strong. And he's durable. And I don't think Canelo going to be able to just do what he want with him. Shakur, of course he the truth. It's my little brother. I'm actually going out there tomorrow. Check on him. You know? I keep my young fella, you know, sharp. He always sharp, though. That's one dude that's a student of the game, that's, you know, he's going to be the next pound-for-pound fighter and the best fighter in the world. Watch. I keep saying it. But he is, though. Ain't nobody messing with him. Teofimo not messing with him. Devin, that's my boy. Him and Devin, if they ever fight, they going to have a chess match. I don't think Tank messing with him. Gary Russell Jr. ain't messing with him. Who else down there? Who else down there? I don't know. Jake Paul McGregor. I got McGregor.
So there you have it. Another great video for ESNews. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram at Elie Seckbach.